Okay, welcome to the next part in the Anime Studio character creation tutorial. This is going to be the last part in the character creation, because then we're going to be moving on to animation and keyframes. So remember where we were before, then we had the character just drawn and coloured in. Now if you remember from the original one, we wanted it coloured in with some shape effects. So what we're going to do is apply those shape effects now. You're going to be using this tool a lot now, Select Shape. So if we click on it, and select the shape we want to modify. Let's start with the body, as it's the biggest. So click on it, and go over to this panel over here. You can change the colour if you wanted to, but we're looking at the effects here. So let's press an effect and change it from plain to splotchy. You see here, here's a preview of what it's going to look like. You can change these settings here to make it more magnitude. Oops. Or less magnitude, or the scale. Play around with these settings to get the effect that you want to get, and then you click OK. Now it doesn't look like anything different, because in a normal window, everything is just rendered plain colours. But if you render it, then you can see you've got this strange effect on the t-shirt. You can do that to the other two arms as well. Or you can add another effect. Let's add shaded. Now, the light angle is going this way. So the shading is on the bottom. Now, because it's on the shoulders, we're going to change it around so we can see it. So the shading is on that side. So click OK. See how it looks. Render it. Well, that's a bit too dark. So we're going to cross that out. Click on it again. And click three dots here, and change the offset so it's less to about 2. Let's click OK and render again. There we go, the shading is more subtle and you can barely see it, but it really does create another effect. Let's do the same to the other shoulder. Okay, there we have our t-shirt with effects. Now the one last bit we're going to do to the t-shirt is the shoulders. Here, the shoulder is very disconnected from the rest of the body. So what we can do is zoom in, and then select this tool over here, which is the Hide Edge tool. And just click on the edges, as if they're not there. Then when you render, it just looks like his arms are part of the shape. You can always bring them back just by clicking on them again, but they're either off or on. You can't change them during animation. It's best to keep it on here, otherwise you've got nothing surrounding him and thin air. Let's turn that back on. So now that's the t-shirt complete, we can move on to another part. Let's do the hair. There are many things you could do to the hair. You could do a gradient, which is where you have two different colours and then it renders going from one to the other. And it doesn't matter what colour you've got on the background, it will be this colour when it renders. So let's just click OK there. You can see that it's brown there, but if you render it, it's gone grey because of the gradient. So we're going to need to change those colours. Change it to a brown and a lighter brown. Let's hit OK and press render to see what it looks like. Now it's going light at the top, dark to the bottom. I don't think that creates a very good effect, so let's change that and turn the angle around. Render it again. That looks a bit better. Now you don't have to be limited to one effect, you can add two effects to each shape. So let's put in a second effect. Let's put shaded on. Change the light angle again. OK, render. And that's looking a bit better already. Now we can move on to the face and the rest of the skin. Now to be careful with the face so we don't make it look too much like it's not a face. So if we put spots on it, it doesn't really look like a face anymore. Equally, if we had shaded, too much. It looks like it's not attached to his neck. So you need to be very careful when doing this. So if we do shaded, then we need to change it to maybe 2 and put the blur up so it's even more subtle. Also, this shading is causing him his face to go grey, and we don't want it to look grey, so we'll change the shadow colour to kind of a dark brown. See, there we go. Now the legs and arms are very thin. They're hardly worth putting any effects on, so we'll just leave them how they are at the moment. The shoes are the same, and the trousers, well, it's up to you really. I'm going to go down to the trousers or shorts and change it to splotchy. Have to do it with both because I coloured them in individually. So now when I render, it's not that noticeable, so I'm going to change the scale a bit. That's better. Okay, so now we've finished doing the shapes, we should adjust the outlines to fit style. Now there's two ways to do the outlines. One is to select the shape like we did. Go over to the outline and type in a number, which is 10. Of course, that's a bit of an exaggeration. You would never have lines that thick. So we'll change that back. But again, lines at 1 also aren't that good, so we can change that to, let's say, 3. A bit too thick, let's turn that down, 2. That's a better outline. We'll have to change up the shoulders too. 2 and 2. You have to decide what you're going to do with the arms. If you think it looks too thick, then you can put it down to 1.5 or... Don't let the lines overpower the rest of the picture. Okay, there we go. We got some lines. Now I can go to the hair and I can show you the other way to adjust lines. Instead of selecting all the lines and making them thicker and thinner, you can select just one point. Go over to here, to the line width tool. Now we can select something, and we can make it thicker and thinner, however much we want. So let's make that thin, and these bits thicker. To make the end of the hair appear more sharp. Make sure you make the line smooth though, don't make it go bigger and smaller, otherwise it won't work. Make sure it goes up smoothly and back down smoothly. You can play around with this as much as you want until you think you've got the right effect. Or you could leave it as it is. I think that does it. You can do the same with the mouth on the line width tool. Just change it so it's more of a smile than a block. So now we have all our effects applied. If you think anything looks too thin or too thick, you can adjust that. If you don't like an effect, you can try changing it. On the next part, we'll be moving on to animation.